What is low-grade wood? So you might hear foresters or loggers talk about two different kinds of wood, low-grade wood and high-grade wood. When we talk about high-grade wood, they're talking about the highest value timber in the forest. So those are the trees that they cut and they become sawlogs, so they get sawn into boards, or if they're really nice, they get turned into veneer, cut into very, very, very thin sheets, and their sheets get glued onto lower value wood. Low grade wood is the logs that are too small or too low quality or too crooked to become a sawlog. They get turned into less valuable wood products like pulp, firewood, sometimes chips for biomass. Now in my channel, I've mentioned the term high grading. High grading is this unethical and short-sighted practice of going into the forest and harvesting only those high-grade logs. Problem with that is, while there are certainly high-grade logs that can be harvested from a forest responsibly, if you target only high-grade logs, you're only cutting the biggest, healthiest trees and you're leaving the less healthy trees behind. And that's a really good way to degrade a forest. Most forest management includes cutting some high-grade logs, but the vast majority of the wood that gets cut in most cases is low-grade logs from unhealthy trees. On most forest management projects, the low-grade wood accounts for about 80% of the volume, which means that only 20% of the volume is in those high-grade logs. However, when you look at the value that comes from that, those proportions get flipped. So about 80% of the value comes from those 20% of logs that are high-grade logs, and 20% of the value comes from those 80% that are low-grade logs. So if you watch this channel, you'll know that I believe that good local markets for forest products are actually essential to ecosystem restoration. Because if we didn't have those markets, everything that we wanted to do in the forest, all these conditions that we want to create and this management work like that I do to try and restore these old growth characteristics, to make our forests more resilient and to create habitats for species of concern, we would have to pay to have all that stuff done. Whereas if we can frame all that stuff within a commercial context, we can get a logger to do it because we're going to sell wood off that project, it allows us to totally explode our capacity to do this restoration work. If we're doing good commercial forest management, we're also generating local renewable resources, which carry with them their own incredible array of global climate change, biodiversity, economic and human rights benefits. One thing that our forestry community has been really struggling with is losing markets and seeing these markets consolidate. When we have lots of good markets for all these different species and all these different forest products, we have a lot of flexibility. We just go into the woods and we do good management and we cut trees that need to be cut. And that's it. When we don't have good markets, we just have less options for what we can do. Now, while high-grade markets might generate more income, low-grade markets are essential to being able to do good forestry. So when we lose something like a pulp mill or a big firewood processor or even a biomass plant, suddenly it makes it way more difficult for us to cut the less healthy trees. And cutting the less healthy trees is a really, really important part of doing good forestry. I'm here at Bear Island and behind me is my firewood pile. My forest, like a lot of forests, was degraded by short-sighted logging practices in the past. When I first came to Bear Island, my impression was that there were no healthy trees left here. When I spent some more time with the land, I realized that there actually are some healthy trees, but in almost every case, they're being competed with by less healthy trees. And so what I do is I find each one of those healthy trees and I release them from competition, cutting the less healthy tree that's competing with them. In the process, I'm also trying to restore some of the species that were targeted by the loggers 30 years ago, especially red oak. This winter was horrible. The ground never froze. I didn't make as much progress as I wanted to, but I still cut about 20 or 30 cords of firewood. And I can say with confidence that every single one of these trees that I cut was a less healthy tree that was competing with a healthier tree, or was an unhealthy tree in an area where no healthy trees were growing at all, and where the best option for the forest was to try to regenerate some trees that had a chance of being healthy in the future. Now, I'm kind of a weirdo, and so if I didn't have a market for these firewood logs, I probably would have cut them and just left them on the ground. However, most people don't have that option. They can't go out and spend days of their lives doing work with absolutely no financial return. And so the fact that someone can go into their woods, do good forestry, do the right thing, make their forest healthier, help it heal from the wounds of the past, help make it more diverse in the future, and then they can generate a product, in this case, firewood, that they can then have a trucker come and pick it up and pay them $125 a cord, that might be the difference between that work getting done or not getting done in most cases. I know that this stuff is really hard to understand, and I know that probably makes no sense to think about, like, that cutting a tree could ever be an act of compassion towards a forest, or that something like a lumber mill could ever be something that's positive for forest ecology. But I'm here to tell you that it can be. As strange as it may seem, having good low-grade markets is a really important part of this.